This is going to be a slightly long one. Hear me out. I want to say first and foremost that while this video is broadly for those who did not vote for the Tangerine Tyrant, it is specifically for Black and Indigenous women and femmes. I'm going to split this into two parts, practical suggestions and philosophical and spiritual thoughts on this entire situation. First things first, learn survival skills. Foraging, hunting, farming, weaponry, etc., etc. Learn how to grow food and herbs. Things are going to get really, really bad in this department really, really quickly. Of course, if you have access to a backyard or garden space, that is ideal. But if you do not, you can also grow small quantities of food in planters in and around your home. Go places in pairs or in small groups. Have groceries and whatever else you need delivered wherever possible. Do not be getting shot up in the Walmart or wherever. Stock up in medicines wherever possible and look for alternative sourcing. Uterus havers, make appointments now for long-term or permanent birth control. You are running out of time. You have options. Make an appointment with your OBGYN or Planned Parenthood, and they will walk you through what options you have available to you. Penis havers, get vasectomies now. Stop making excuses. They will let your uterus having partner or spouse die if they become pregnant and there's a problem with the pregnancy, or they become pregnant by accident or as the result of an assault. Put some sperm on ice and get it done. Wherever you can, move money into more fluid financial platforms like Revolut, Wise, etc., because they are certainly going to come after women's wealth rights. If you can, and this is what you want, leave. If you are fortunate enough to have a remote job, you can cycle tourist visas utilizing short-term housing or hostels until you are able to settle somewhere more permanently. If you can't leave, hide. If you can't hide, get ready to fight. The United States of America has been in the early stages of a civil war for some years now. That war is going to come to your doorstep. Be ready. Do not go anywhere unarmed. Yes, I fucking said it. Do not go anywhere unarmed. These Nazis will stab you or shoot you and dump you in a dumpster for you to die. Don't give them the chance. Community organizers, do not organize online, period. Make use of analog methods of communication, data recording, and note-taking. Asylum may be an option for some marginalized Americans, especially Black and LGBTQ Americans. Moving abroad generally is not as expensive or as impossible as you may think. And yes, even disabled people may be able to receive visas. Visa awards vary heavily by country, so think about where you might want to go. Start doing the homework now. If you're able to, seek work in foreign countries. There is a high demand for English teachers, especially in East Asia, Southeast Asia, and Central and South America. Typically, only a bachelor's degree is required for this. Consider studying in a foreign country, especially at the master's level or higher. This can make it easier to stay in the long term. Look into immigration programs like the EU Blue Card, skilled worker visas, the global talent visas, and stuff like that. If you own land, consider opening it up to communal settlement to help people stay safe and to help provide for one another. Start or join a community garden or farmstead. Put your money where your mouth is, especially if you claim to be an ally to the marginalized of America. That means donating to Black bail funds, abortion funds, civil rights organizations and outfits, and all the rest of it. Action, not words. I'm not going to suggest specific social media creators at this time because in all likelihood, US side social media platforms may be shut down or severely restricted. So do that research on your own, save what you can offline, back up your machines. Renew your license and passport now. Expedited if possible. Make sure that you know where all of your vital documents are and where all the vital documents of your family are. Prepare a go bag. You may need to leave quickly. Make sure that your family is ready to leave quickly too. Finally, practice self-care aggressively, especially Black and Indigenous women and femmes. Practice self-care in every department. Make sure that you are looked after, or we can't help anyone, never mind ourselves. This is a horrific time for the United States, not just for the United States, but for the world. We are entering a long night of the soul after a lengthy twilight. The darkness is deep and hazardous. I am not going to lie to you. Not all of us will survive this. And yet, that is the current objective. Survive. Be a light in the darkness. Be a river in a dry land. Remember that light is not only how we see in darkness. It is a searing, brilliant, directive force. And it can destroy as well as illuminate. Keep your lamps lit when all other lights have gone out. And through deepening darkness, light it up as bright as day and watch it burn. Stay balanced. Stay doing your shadow work. The wise warrior wins the fight. I wish us healing.